Blackstone Publishing presents And the Bride Closed the Door by Ronit Matalon, translated by Jessica Cohen. This book is read by Deepti Gupta. For my son, Daniel. The young bride, who had been locked in her room in utter silence for more than 5 hours, finally made her announcement, then repeated the astonishing declaration 3 times from behind the closed door, through which 4 pairs of ears listened anxiously and with the utmost devotion. Not getting married. Not getting married. Not getting married. She recited in a flat, almost bored voice that sounded extremely distant and nebulous, like the final vapors of a scented cleaning spray. 3 of them were crowded into the sad hallway. The grandmother had been placed upon a wicker stool opposite the door when her feet had grown weary from the long wait, and avoided looking at one another for a long time, as though any eye contact might turn the declaration they had just heard into a solid fact, confirming not only its content, but worse, its significance. And so they simply continued to stare at the shut door with its old-fashioned dark wood veneer, seemingly anticipating a thawing, a softening, a miraculous melting, if not of the bride, then at least of the door, and hoping for something further. A continuation of the sentence, an idea, or a word that might emerge through the door like the wet head of a newborn closely followed by the body itself sliding out. I'm cold, said the bride's mother, Nadia. She tried to encircle her fleshy shoulders with her own arms, which were encased in the tight-fitting, prickly lace sleeves of the light gray evening gown she had been trying on at the hairstylist's request, though her feet were absent-mindedly clad in plaid winter slippers with zippers down the front. Her dyed blonde quiff perked up in surprise over her forehead, and similar wonderment veiled her gaze when it unintentionally fell on the grandmother, her own elderly mother, by whose presence she seemed as perplexed as she might be by an unfamiliar piece of furniture that she had not ordered yet was suddenly delivered to her home.
What did Margie say?
The grandmother asked cheerfully. She was hard of hearing and generally not with us, as Nadia put it. And throughout all these hours of waiting, she had sustained a dazzling smile, full of the pearly white teeth inlaid by the dentist only a week earlier in honor of the wedding.
What did she say?
She repeated, hanging her round gaze on the chrome door handle, which was positioned precisely at her eye level. She sat on the stool with her legs obediently straight and close together, like a kindergartner at circle time, and patted the remaining 2 apple quarters, 2 she had already eaten, on a dish towel on her lap. Nadia leaned over and gripped her elbow. Go on, go rest in the living room for now. We'll let you know when there's any news. The grandmother munched on some apple, and a thin dribble of pale yellow juice ran from the corner of her mouth down to her chin.
Booze? What booze? They'll have plenty of drinks at the catering hall, don't worry,
she assured them, wiping her fingertips on the dish towel. The phone rang in Matai's pocket. He quickly silenced it, but a few seconds later it ran again, and he turned it off yet again.
It's not her, asked Nadia. It's not her, the groom replied. I have her phone, did you forget?
Nadia closed her heavily made-up eyes.
I didn't forget. I didn't know you had it. How could I forget something I didn't know?
She paused.
What are we going to do?
Then she repeated her question more quietly, as if trying not to wake someone.
What are we going to do?
Matai looked at her intently, somewhat wistful, yet completely alert, and seemed to be considering her question, although he wasn't really. She could feel his gaze jabbing her in the spot right between her painted eyebrows with an injection of despair, tense expectation, and something else she couldn't quite name.
Startled, she turned sharply to Ilan, her nephew, who was leaning over on her right and whispering in her ear.
What? What did you say?
Nadia was confused.
I corrected you, I said.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.